Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to talk about why it's very difficult to become a solutions architect in the cloud industry or any other part of IT in a very short period of time. Now, of course, I'm a teacher, I teach at Digital Cloud Training, I teach people solutions architecture, including the AWS Certified Solutions Architect Associate Training. But at the same time, I just want to be realistic with people about what you can achieve. Now, I want everyone to aim high and actually achieve what they want in life. That is absolutely what I'm here for. Now, every day, I do have students coming to me who have no experience in the industry, and they say, how can I become a solutions architect? Now, the point I want to make in this video is not to dissuade you from taking that road and going down that path. I think that's a very great thing to do. It's an exciting industry. I loved working as a solutions architect for many, many years. I just want to be a bit realistic about how you're going to get there, to set you up for success so that you know the steps you need to go through and the experience you need to gain in order to move into that type of position. So a solutions architect position is not a junior position, it's a senior position. So you have to understand that for the most part, you're going to need a significant amount of experience in the industry before you can take one of those roles. So let's investigate a little bit about what a solutions architect does, and then you'll understand how you're going to go about moving towards attaining that role through gaining experience, gaining certifications, and just working in the industry and building yourself up through various other roles before you get there. Now, I know that some people are going to say, well, I started in the industry as a solutions architect, and then a small company, that might be true. But in any large company, any kind of corporate enterprise environment, a solutions architect role is not somewhere you're going to start out. You're going to start in a junior position if you don't have experience. So let's have a look at what a solutions architect does, and then you'll gain a bit of an understanding and an insight into what you need to do to get there. Now, I worked in the industry for well over 20 years. I'm a teacher now, but when I was working in the industry as a consultant, I worked for systems integration companies as a senior solutions architect or an enterprise architect. Systems integration companies are companies that other companies will look to bring in consulting expertise when they don't have the skills or they don't have the time to perform complex projects themselves. So I would come in as a consultant and talk to these customers and work out what it is they want to do and design a solution for them. Now, in doing so, they would tell me various information about their business objectives, their financial objectives, how flexible they need to be, how dynamic they need to be, what the security requirements, the performance requirements, the backup and restore requirements, all of these different factors. So to be able to come up with a solution, I of course would leverage lots of subject matter expertise. But I needed to have a good, solid understanding of all of these different facets of the solution myself as well. So that means I needed knowledge of compute, Linux and Windows, containers and virtualization, servers and storage systems, network systems, database systems, backup and restore systems, data center architecture, and of course the application layer as well. I would need to understand about DNS, I would need to understand about directory systems like Active Directory, and the various different applications and what those applications would need in the data center environment. And with this different knowledge, I can then come up with the sort of high-level plan of what a solution would be that would meet those requirements. Now, in different organizations, you may find that a solutions architect role is a bit more specialized in one area and not necessarily that broad. But at the same time, it always relies on quite a bit of fundamental knowledge and experience in the industry. Really, the only way you can gain that kind of knowledge is working in the industry. Certifications can really help as well, but there's absolutely no substitute to working in the industry for a number of years before you have that level of knowledge that you can move into an architecture role. So what does this mean for you? Well, if you already have industry experience working in IT, working in cloud, then you may be able to do certifications like the Solutions Architect Associate and Professional level and move into an architecture role because you're building on that fundamental knowledge and experience you have. If you're beginning in IT, then I suggest you see it as a more longer-term goal. Get the certifications and then get a job at a more junior level, something that you can get into, start gaining experience. And that experience is really going to set you up for the future. That could be a cloud support role. It could be a cloud engineer role. It can be something development or systems operations related, or it could be as a technical account manager, for example. Those are just a few ideas. There's lots of job roles for people coming in at that type of level. And in those roles, you will gain experience of the industry. You will start understanding more about the sort of considerations you'll need to understand when you become a solutions architect. And then you can work your way from there. So again, I want to set you up for success. I want to give you some realistic expectations about how you can start training yourself, getting that experience, and then moving towards that dream role. So I hope you found this useful. Please subscribe to our channel and like this video if you want to see more like this.